Welcome to my Programming in Swift series of videos. Today we're going to create a simple command line tool using Xcode and Swift 2. So the objective is to be able to execute this from the command line, pass in some arguments, and get some feedback. All right, so I'm going to create a new Xcode project. It'll be a command line tool. I'll call it CLTool. Make sure Swift is selected for my language, and I'll just put it in my lesson 1 directory. I'll click on main.swift to open it in the editor, and we'll just get rid of our little hello world stub here. So during the course of this project, we're going to cover 4 different topics. The first is declaring and defining variables and constants using the let and bar keywords. We're going to cover the int, string, and array value types. We're going to cover the process enum. And you can find the documentation for that at swiftdoc.org. And we're going to do a control structure, the for loop. So the way to get command line arguments in Swift is through the predefined enum called process. I'm going to declare 2 constants and assign them values based on some properties of this process enum. My first constant will get the count of arguments from the command line. I'll say let argc, which is of type int, equal process.argc. Now you'll notice we get an error here. Cannot convert value of type c int, so we need to convert this property to an int value type. It is an iterable, but it's not technically an int value type, so we'll just wrap this up in a call to int. And then I'll debug by saying print you passed in argc arguments. Build and run. And so you'll see our feedback is you passed in 1 argument. Well, you may say, wait, not only is that grammatically atrocious, but I didn't actually pass in any arguments. Well, the first argument in the argv array is always the program itself, so that's the one it's counting. So I'm actually going to go up here to my declaration. Just to make the feedback more semantically accurate, I'll subtract 1 from the argc definition. So now when we run it, our feedback says, you passed in 0 arguments, which seems more true in any case. I'll append my comment to read not including 0, which is the program itself. Okay, my next declaration will be to assign arguments to an array. I'll say let argv, which is an array of string type, equal process.arguments. Now I'll iterate through all but 0, which is the program itself. I'll do this in a for loop. I'll say for var I equals 1. The condition will be I is less than argc plus 1. And I'll just wrap that little expression in some parentheses to be explicit. And we'll just use the unary operator to increment I. And in the body of this loop, I'll just say print argument I was argv I. And then we'll just do product build, because we're going to go out and test this from the command line. So I'll flip down the products show in Finder, drag that out to my terminal window, and we'll see that if I pass no arguments, I get the message I expect. But if I pass in some arguments, we'll say, hello, world, and run it, we get the feedback we anticipate. So we can actually copy this out to someplace in our path, say copy cltool to user local bin cltool, and then we can just call it by typing cltool.